Hi, hello, my dear students. To continuing my lectures on the topic motion in a straight line, today I would like to discuss a new topic, problems on average speed and average velocity. Already I discussed what is meant by average speed and what is meant by average velocity and what are the note points of average speed and average velocity. These are I discussed in previous lectures. Now I would like to discuss problems on average speed and average velocity. Few problems I discuss based upon this concept. After completion of these problems, you got a clear idea about this average speed and average velocity. Right. So first problem, example one. A person travels along a straight road for half the distance with a velocity v1. If a person, I consider person will be traveled on the road half of the distance traveled with velocity v1, and the remaining half distance traveled with velocity v2. Remaining half distance is traveled with velocity v2. The average velocity is, so what we need to find, ma? So we need to find average velocity. We need to find here. So for example, so this is initial position, this is the final position. The person is here, person is traveled on a straight road. He moves half of the distance. So this is half distance and this one is another half distance. Let us consider this total distance is x kilometers. Total distance is x kilometers. Then this distance is x by 2. This distance is x by 2. Total distance is x kilometers. This half distance is x by 2 meters. This half distance is also x by 2 kilometers. So what they given in the question? Observe carefully, ma'am. Half of the distance is moves with velocity v1. So this half distance is traveled with velocity v1. And another half distance is traveled with velocity v2. Then what we need to find here? Average velocity we need to find in that question. Right? So average velocity is equal to total, what is formula for average velocity, ma? Already I discussed in previous lecture. Please recapitulate. And one more thing, if you follow my regular classes, my regular lectures, so you must cover previous lectures, because these lectures are linked lectures. If you watch that previous lectures only, you got idea about these lectures. Please watch previous lectures. So I told here one formula about average velocity. What is the formula for average velocity here? Average velocity is equal to total displacement by total time taken. Total displacement is, so total displacement is what, ma? This is initial position, this is final position. What is meant by displacement? The shortest path between initial and final position. What is the shortest path between initial and final position? Total displacement is x. Total displacement is here x kilometers. And total time taken. Let us consider for this half. Time is I consider as t1. For this half distance, time taken is I consider as t2. Then total time means what we taking here? T1 plus T2. Already you know velocity is equal to displacement by time, right? Velocity is equal to displacement by time. That means here time is equal to, what is formula for time here? Time is equal to displacement by velocity. From this formula, time is equal to displacement by velocity. This is very important. By using this formula, we write here time is equal to displacement by velocity. For this half distance, observe carefully, for this half distance s by 2 km, velocity is v1, time is t1. For this half distance, time t1 is equal to what we got? Time is equal to, what is the formula here? Displacement by velocity. What is displacement here? S by 2 is displacement. What is velocity here? V1 is velocity here. That means what we got here? X by 2 V1. Time T1 is equal to what we got here? X by 2 V1 we got. And another half distance, time is equal to, already you know, time is equal to displacement by velocity. For this half, time T2 is equal to, displacement is S by 2, velocity is V2. Then what we got? X by 2 V2. X by 2 V2. So this is T2. We got, substitute this T2 and T1 value here. So we got X by T1 value is X by 2 V1. X by 2 V1. T2 value is X by 2 V2. So then from this X by X is common it. What we got? X by 2 is common it. We got 1 by V1 plus 1 by V2. Thus X going to be cancelled. Finally we got this 2 will be moves numerator 2 by 1 by V1 plus 1 by V2. That is equal to 2 V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. 2 V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. That means, observe carefully here, whenever one body travels on straight road, half of the distance is travelled in V1 meter per second, another half distance is travelled in V2 meter per second, then average velocity covered by body is equal to, we got formula is what? 2 V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. What we got formula? Average velocity. So please listen students, whenever like this problems are given, half distance is covered in V1 meter per second, another half distance is covered in V2 meter per second, then what is meant by average velocity? Like this problems are asked, then you should take directly formula 2 V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. This is very important. 2 V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. This is the answer for this question. Observe which option is suitable now. Option D is correct here. Average velocity is equal to 2 V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. This is very important. Half distance covered in V1 meter per second, another half distance is covered in V2 meter per second. Like this questions are asking, then you directly apply average velocity formula 2 V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. Well, to continue my lecture, problems on average speed and average velocity. Problem number 2. A car travels from A to B at a speed 20 km per hour and returns at a speed 30 km per hour. The average speed of car for the whole journey is. What is given question here? A car travels a speed of 20 km per hour and it returns back with a speed of 30 km per hour. What is average speed of car for the whole journey? What we need to find? Average speed of car for the whole journey we need to find here. So we need to find average speed of car. So we need to find. Okay. So what they given in the question? So I represent as a diagrammatic here. So this is point A. This is point B. What they given? From A to B, car is moves with a speed of 20 kilometers per hour. First car is travels like this from A to B. It travels 20 kilometers per hour. And again returns back. That means it moves again B to A. So now car is moves from B to A with a speed of 30 km/h. 30 km/h. What is average speed of journey? How to find here? So finding average speed. Average speed formula. Total distance by simple thing here. Average velocity means total displacement by total time. Average speed means total distance by total time. Speed is related with distance. Velocity is related with displacement. This is important. Average speed is equal to total distance by total time taken. So total distance is what here? Let us consider. So A to B distance is some x kilometers I consider. Total distance. So A to B x kilometers. Again B to A x kilometers. Total distance traveled is x plus x, 2x kilometers. Please listen friends here. Car moves from A to B and again return back to B to A. That means distance between A to B is x kilometers and again return back to A means again x kilometers. Total distance is x kilometers plus x kilometers. So total distance. Total time taken. Let us consider. Time is here. T1 I consider. Here time taken is T2 I consider. Total time is T1 plus T2. So we got here 2x by T1 plus T2. So for finding T1, how to find T1? Already you know speed is equal to distance by time. We know this formula. How to find time here? Time is equal to, from this formula, time is equal to distance by speed. Observe carefully, ma. Speed is equal to formula distance by time. From this, time is equal to distance by speed. So here T1 value, T2 value we need to find. How to find T1 value here? T1 is equal to, T1 means time taken from A to B. So from time taken from A to B, distance is what? Time is equal to distance by speed. Now, what is distance from A to B? Distance is x kilometers by speed is 20 km/h. X by 20 we got. And again, T2 means B to A. B to A is also distance is x kilometers only. Same distance. But traveled with a speed of 30 km. 30 km/h. So x by 20 and x by 30 here. Substitute those values. T1 and T2 values. 2x by, what is T1 value here? X by 20. What is T2 value? X by 30. X by 20 plus x by 30. From this 2x is equal to, x is common, it what we got here? 1 by 20 plus 1 by 30. This x and x, this numerator and denominator x is going to be cancelled. Finally we got 2 by 1 by 20 plus 1 by 30. So from this, how we got from this we got 2 into 20 into 30 by 20 plus 30. So from this we got 2 into 20 into 30 by 20 plus 30 is 50. 0, 0 cancel. 5 4s we got here. 4 2s 8. 8 3s 24. So total what we got my here? 24 kilometers per hour. So average speed travel is equal to 24 kilometers per hour here. So that means whenever like these questions are given, if body is traveled with a speed, certain speed from A to B, again it returned back with a speed, certain speed is given. For example, general question, how they asking? If a body travels with a speed of v1 kilometers per hour and again it returned back with the speed of v2 kilometers per hour. Okay, I wrote here note point. I think you all are understood this problem. Same question asked in general format. General format. How they ask in general format? Note point. So from this we got two note points here. If a body moves half of distance with velocity v1 meter per second and another half with v2 meter per second, then average velocity is, what is formula? Direct formula, 2v1 v2 by v1 plus v2. Already we solved few minutes back. What is relation here? 2v1 v2 by v1 plus v2. This is first note point. And next, second note point. If a body travels from A to B with speed or velocity. Velocity is given here. Velocity is v1 meter per second. So we consider speed also. With the speed v1 meter per second and returns back with a speed v2 meter per second, then average speed is formula 2v1 v2 by v1 plus v2 only. So these two are note points. Whenever like these questions are given, body is traveled with certain speed from A to B, again it returned back with another v2 speed. So like that questions are given. Average speed formula 2v1 v2 by v1 plus v2 is the formula for this question. So and body is traveled half of the distance with v1 meter per second and again another half will be covered with another v2 meter per second, then average velocity formula 2v1 v2 by v1 plus v2. These two note points are important for solving questions. These two are simple tips. So while any question is given like this format, you directly apply this formula. Thank you very much.